In this video, we'll examine why the derivative of e to the power x is equal to e to the power of x, using the limit definition of derivative, also known as the first principle. To prove this, we'll utilize the limit definition of the derivative formula and the fact that the limit of 1 plus n to the power of 1 over n as n approaches 0 is defined as Euler's number e. We'll now prove that the derivative of e to the power of x is e to the power of x, using the limit definition of derivative and the definition of Euler's number shown in green. Let's define f of x as e to the power of x, which means f of x plus h is equal to e to the power of x plus h. If you substitute these expressions into green formula, the numerator can be expressed as e to the power of x plus h minus e to the power of x, and the denominator remains as h. By observing the numerator, we can see that e to the power of x is a common factor. We can factorize e to the power of x and rewrite the expression as e to the power of x times e to the power of h minus 1 over h, where the limit is taken as h approaches 0. Since this limit condition involves h approaching 0, the variable x is independent of h, allowing us to bring e to the power of x outside the limit. Therefore, we have e to the power of x times the limit of e to the power of h minus 1 over h. Now, if we find the value of the expression inside the orange box, we can determine the derivative of e to the power of x. To find the limit value, let's substitute e to the power of h minus 1 with n. As h approaches 0, n also approaches 0, then we can express e to the power of h as 1 plus n, and by taking the natural logarithm of both sides, we have ln e to the power of h equals ln 1 plus n, simplifying the left side to h. Now, let's apply these three substitutions and conditions to the previous limit expression. The derivative of f prime of x is equal to e to the power of x times the limit expression where the numerator e to the power of h minus 1 is replaced with n, and the denominator h is replaced with ln 1 plus n. Next, we multiply 1 over n to both the numerator and the denominator. The numerator becomes 1, and the denominator becomes 1 over n times ln 1 plus n. By utilizing the properties of logarithms and moving 1 over n as the exponent, we obtain e to the power of x times the limit of 1 over ln 1 plus n to the power of 1 over n. Since the current limit condition involves n approaching 0, we can apply the limit inside the logarithm function. Therefore, this expression can be written as e to the power of x times 1 over ln limit of 1 plus n to the power of 1 over n. And we can see that this limit value is Euler's number, denoted as e, as shown earlier. So this expression simplifies to e to the power of x times 1 over ln e, and the fraction denominator simplifies to 1, ultimately leaving us with e to the power of x. In this way, we have demonstrated using the limit definition of derivative and Euler's number why the derivative of e to the power of x is e to the power of x. How did you find today's video? If it was helpful, please consider subscribing and liking the video. I will continue to create videos that can assist you in your mathematical learning. Thank you for watching. I've been your math guardian, Alex.